The following glossopharyngeal method is rarely used. It does, however, find a place in children with extensive larynx stenosis who have had a temporary tracheostomy. The patient demonstrated cannot be understood from this record, but in spite of this limited method of communication, the patient has nonetheless achieved a method of speech. The sound of the glossopharyngeal speech bears a striking resemblance to that sound produced by a frog, and it is therefore called frog speech. First, you will hear the frog sound, after which the glossopharyngeal sound will be demonstrated.
It's me, Wilkes.